This is José Quesada for Data Science Retreat. Today I want to talk to you about one thing that I've been thinking about for a while, which is what do you want to achieve with a project in AI or in machine learning or in data science, right? People all care about having projects, having something to show, and so on, but there are different levels. This is something that I really want to go deeper, right? So, what a project, and most people only want to learn a skill set with that project, which is fine, it's a perfectly fine goal to have, but there are like different levels here, and I think my point with this video is that you should go for the last one, because if you fail, you have kind of a failback on one of the others, right? Learning a skill set, that's a given. No matter what project you are going to do, you want to learn something. Not a big deal, right? Now, one other goal would be to look competent, and the real goal is to find a job. This is also very common. Oh, I'm doing this just because I want to put it on my LinkedIn and my GitHub, and I'm going to get the attention of recruiters or hiring managers. Fine, you want to get a job. That's totally fine. So there's a difference between these two, right? It could be that the thing that you do for learning a skill set is not the same thing that you do to look hireable. Right? Now we're getting to deeper things, right? So you want to solve a real problem with your project. That's not very common. I would like it to be more common, but it's not. So I see people saying, oh, I want to have social impact, I want to help people, I want to solve real problems, but it's very unlikely that you find people doing something about it with machine learning. And if it's totally doable, there's plenty of low-hanging fruit here. There's plenty of things that you can do in machine learning today to solve a real problem that real people have. And it's kind of a shame that we are not doing more of it. Okay, so that would be one more goal that is kind of deeper than looking competent to get a job, right? There's one more level, which is to create a product. And a product is not only a project, it's a product because you can charge for it. This is something that is packaged in a way that these people that have a real problem and maybe can pay for it are willing to do something about it. That is a product. And most people, I would say 99% of the people that I deal with day to day, never get to the point where they build a project or take a project and build it to a point where they can charge for it. This is not a criticism. There is a real reason for this. Traditional companies, they all want ads, right? And they don't get there that easily. You know how much money and effort companies, real big companies, spend trying to figure out what to build, and if you build it, how to market it, and so on. It's totally fine if you as an individual, you cannot get to this point and build something that you can charge for. But there is a big but, right? So yes, all these companies spend a lot of money doing all these kind of big company things like doing market research, focus group, doing marketing, trying to get data from the users and use that data to sell them something like Netflix does, right? Netflix produces series that are influenced by the data that they collect. Sometimes you see a series and you can see, oh, this was targeted to teenage women who are overweight, and they would love that series. How do they find out that there is a market that would want to consume that series? Because they have data, and they know who is watching them, they know things about the person watching, right? Okay, so the big difference between you and these big corporations is that they need to solve a problem that affects millions, ideally billions of people, right? That's Google, for example. Google will never start a new project if it doesn't affect billions of people. So that limits their options quite a bit, right? They are kind of the king of the jungle for machine learning. There is no other company doing better with machine learning so far than Google. They are probably good at products as well. You can question that because they kill a lot of products, right? But they have a problem, which is they need to build products for billions of people. You don't have a problem. You can go to a tiny little narrow group of people that you know very well and help them. And then you know them so well, you may be one of them, that they will identify with you, you will identify their problems, it will be a beautiful match between the two of you, right? Okay. So here, there are some ways to think if you are going to go for the product part of it, right? So you're going to go for this part where you want to create a product that you want to charge for. I'm not saying that you need to do that, but if you want to go that way, there are like different scales, right? Sometimes you come up with an idea and you want people to use it, but they actually don't. They're like, you know, I don't have time. Then you pay people to use it, or you promise them a favor. Oh, if you fill this questionnaire, imagine that your product is a questionnaire, I'm going to give you, I don't know, a chance to win a MacBook Air, right? You pay people to do something for you. That's kind of one stream. The other stream is where they pay you, and they will be sad if your thing doesn't exist anymore. So you want to be moving from this to this. Right? I'm not saying that this is easy. This is something that companies, big and small, like startups as well, struggle with. Now, you can be undifferentiated, you can be one of the many to-do lists, right? Or you are the first solution that people think about. And you want to go this way as well, right? This is hard as hell, right? You can go from guessing the problem to be in a spot where you know the problem really well. You are the guy who knows about the problem the most in the world, and you have the solution. That is a wonderful place to be. So you want to go in that direction, right? Last one is you are consuming, you read a lot, you see blog posts about companies being built, about people making money with products. Maybe somebody just came up with something as simple as a newsletter. They're making money with it. You read the newsletter, you consume, you want to go to the point where you produce, where you write, and people follow you because of what you write. This is the place you want to be, right? Super hard, any of these things, right? You normally start here and you move towards this. What is one hack to get all these scales much faster to move to the right? I'm going to tell you. Niche. So if you can get to a niche and you can be the person that, okay, let's look at the scales now, assuming that you are in a niche, right? It's easier to get people to pay you if you are targeting the right people and they have a problem that is very narrow to themselves. It's a problem that is worth to pay for. You're probably the first solution to think about if you are the one person talking about this, that nobody else cares about it, but you do, and you care very much. You're building, you know the problem very well, and you're building a solution for that niche, right? You can be producing and writing about that niche, and then it's easy for people to follow you, to find you, and so on. So all these things become easier if you niche down. And this is actually the big advantage that you have over Google. You don't need to create a product for a billion people, you need a product for a few thousands, and that's probably enough. You're going to be looking competent, as I said, you're going to learn a lot, you're going to solve a real problem, and you may be able to charge for it. This is why I'm trying to convince you in this video that it's much easier for you in every possible way to aim to create a product that you charge for, and then degrade into these other things as you go along. Companies are going to be impressed as hell if you show up and show a product that you build with your hands that solves a real problem and you will charge for it. This is something that I would hire if I ever see it on my doorstop. To the data scientist, all things equal. If one of them has done this, way out of the league of anybody else. Okay, this is what I have for today. So if you want to think about why you want to create a product, I have all these things to say, and I think you should go for a product, not a project, but a product.